Hello, hello, hello. A very good evening to all of you. My name is Siddharth Vishwanathan, Editor-in-Chief of SportsLumo.com. And in this special episode of 50 Greatest Olympic Moments for India, I'm going to bring you another interesting anecdote. We have focused in previous episodes, folks, about how Rio 2016 proved to be an ultimate disaster for India. There was so much of heartbreak. But in this episode of 50 Greatest Olympic Moments for India, I am going to bring to you a story of luck, of tremendous fortune, of skill, of heartbreak. Social media existed back then, folks, and I'm sure the word repechage would have been searched billions of times by Indians. Because one particular wrestler was in the cusp of securing a historic medal. I'm talking about Sakshi Malik. Haryana has produced tremendous wrestlers, folks. And it was the exploits of Sushil, Kumar and Yogeshwar, Dutt that got India on the map in wrestling in the Olympics. Sushil Kumar with a bronze and a silver in 2008 and 2012. Yogeshwar Dutt with a bronze. But in Rio 2016, Sakshi Malik was almost not going to be there. I will come back to that instance later. Even in the tournament, Sakshi Malik was not touted as one of the medal contenders. There was PV Sindhu, Saina Nehwal, Abhinav Bindra, Jitu Rai, Gagan Narang, and several other Indian athletes who were touted to win medals for India. But as I had mentioned, the heartbreak and the trauma that happened, Sindhu losing out on gold, Bindra missing out on a medal, so the other shooters as well, meant that suddenly one or two players became the dark horse in getting the medal. Even before Sakshi, all eyes were on Vinesh Fogart. Vinesh Fogart at that particular time was tipped to be the medal favorite because she had won plenty of medals before the Olympics, be it in the Asian Games, be it the Commonwealth Games. Vinesh had done it all. But in her encounter against Sun Yunan of China, her knee was fractured. Not fractured, her knee was injured. Some feared the worst for Vinesh, but thankfully it needed just surgery. It wasn't broken, neither it was fractured. So in wrestling, only Sakshi Malik remained. India desperately needed some good luck. With Sindhu's silver, India had found something to be happy about. But otherwise, everywhere else, it was despair and nothing but despair. Did you almost know that Sakshi Malik did not make it to the 2016 Rio Olympics? It is an interesting family tussle. And also, how one decision by her relative gave Sakshi the ticket. Sakshi Malik had secured bronze medals in Asian Championships. In several other tournaments, she had also won the gold and silver medals. But in her weight category, 58 kilos, Sakshi Malik's cousin, Geeta Fogart, was the ultimate champion. But before the Tokyo Olympics in 2015, Geeta Fogart was appointed as the flag bearer. But in one particular competition in Mongolia, Sakshi forfeited her repechage home. And that did not please the Wrestling Federation of India. So Geeta was shown the door and Sakshi Malik was given the chance to represent India in the Olympics. She won events and she finished just about right to ensure that she got the ticket to Rio. That was the odds that Sakshi Malik had to face in her journey to Rio. Underwritten Without much doubt, Sakshi Malik began her journey. She started off well with a couple of wins. But against Russia Skoblova, she lost in the quarterfinals. Luckily for Sakshi, Skoblova entered the final. So in wrestling, the competitor who enters the final, all the opponents whom she had beaten had gone into the single repechage. What is the repechage? This is the repechage. Every opponent that has been defeated, and if that same player reaches the final, then everybody else goes into the repechage. Sakshi was defeated by Skoblova and hence she went into the repechage. She won her first two games and was just one win away from a bronze medal. Against Asian champion Tyurinkova of Kazakhstan, Sakshi was trailing 5-0. Tyurinkova was on the cusp of securing the medal and ensuring India would not have a single medal in wrestling. But with 2 minutes to go, Sakshi was in top form. Her desperation showed. Within minutes, she leveled the score at 5-5. And in one crucial move, Sakshi turned the tables around and she was leading 8-5. It was a remarkable recovery by Sakshi Malik and it was one of the greatest comebacks in the history of wrestling. Sakshi defeated Tyurinkova and finally, history was created. For the first time in Indian history, a female wrestler had secured a medal in the Olympics. After Yogeshwar Dutt and Sushil Kumar, it was the turn of Sakshi Malik to etch her name in the history books. It was a tremendous feeling for 1.3 billion Indians. At least, they had gotten one more medal. Haryana had once again produced a champion who became one of the best in the business. Rio 2016 was the zenith. One hopes that wrestling's legacy carries on in Tokyo 2020, because Vinesh Fogat, from all the hurt of 2016, will now get a chance for the ultimate redemption. If she does it, then Haryana will establish itself as the wrestling capital of India. Anyways, it is a tremendous sporting hub with hockey, wrestling and several other disciplines coming from that state. But Sakshi Malik's victory ensured that girl power ruled the roost. In 2016, both the medals were won by girls, PV Sindhu and Sakshi Malik. With that, folks, I end this special episode of SportsLumo's 50 Greatest Olympic Moments for India. I will be back with more anecdotes in the upcoming episodes. In the next episode, I will focus upon how one army man gave a nation plenty to smile about. That is in the upcoming episode of SportsLumo's 50 Greatest Olympic Moments for India. Press the subscribe button, tap the bell icon, like, comment and share, folks, and spread the word of SportsLumo's 50 Greatest Olympic Moments for India. Thank you. Stay safe.